Hi, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, and today I wanted to talk to you a little bit more about uprighting molars. I get a lot of doctors that come to me at Straight Smile Solutions who want to do this, and they don't realize how incredibly difficult it can be. There's a lot of variables that come into play in terms of case selection. There's some easier ones, and there's a lot of hard ones. So I just kind of wanted to go over a few techniques and just list a few variables. Ultimately, I think unless you've done a bunch of them, you really should have someone helping you out initially so that you don't screw it up. And like with any type of uprighting or exposures or impactions, there's no guarantees with this. So of course you want to make sure your patient is signing the consent form. Your informed consent for braces should have a section on that. But beyond that, I like to always create my own like unique consent form, going over the risk benefits and alternatives of molar uprighting or exposures, because I've had the experience before where I've had some of these and they signed the informed consent and we went over it verbally and all that, and I made chart notes saying we discussed it and the parents understood it wouldn't work, there's a chance it wouldn't work, you know, and yeah, and then push comes to shove and you know we hit the wall, it wasn't possible for whatever reason, we tried. You know, if they appeal with the insurance company, you're paying them back. I mean, that's the best case scenario. It could be worse. So you really need to write down that conversation and have them sign it. That would just be my suggestion, just to cover your CYA. But anyways, so different variables you're going to be looking at will really depend on the angulation of the molar. You know, like obviously this one is only angulated like maybe like 20, 30 degrees, right? It's mesio-angulated a little bit. You know, some are completely horizontal. Those are going to have a much less favorable prognosis than something that's just slightly angulated, you know. So I'm going to say maybe less than 40 degrees angulation is going to have a better prognosis than something bigger. What else? Obviously, root development. Is there a third molar back here? Would be one thing that would make it easier or harder. My suggestion is shut that third molar out, even if it's early. Get it out. It's going to make your life way, way easier. What else? And let it heal, of course, before you start doing it. What else? Bone level, root level, perio, stuff like that. Obviously, the more bone, better. More crown to root ratio, better. Things like that. Same thing with the healthy of the other dentition. How much of the other dentition is in? Do we have a full set? Are we missing some? Obviously, it's better if we have a full set because we need to have a counter moment. We need to brace against something. And if there's not a lot of teeth there to brace against, it's going to be difficult. You can do it sectional, but personally, I like just do the whole arch. It's just way, way easier. And often the bite gets all funky when you do this. You try not, but it's going to. You can do it with Invisalign. I've definitely done it with Invisalign, but you're going to need to put an attachment on it, like a big guy. So if you've got a gold crown or a porcelain crown, you might have to damage it. So just keep that in mind. What else? Third molars, of course, age of the patient would be better, right? Younger patient, you know, 12, 13, 14, 15, gonna have more success than a 50-year-old. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. So this is one of my techniques that I do here. Like I said, I don't normally just do a sectional wire, but for the graphic's sake, it made more sense. But I'll align the other teeth up first, get into a nice heavy nitai, like maybe a 1925 nitai. I will flame the end of it. I'll kind of measure it and make sure there's a little bit extra. And I will flame it. Put in a nice nitai open coil spring here, and I will steel tie the adjacent teeth so that hopefully it stays in really good. And I'll activate the open coil spring. Remember, it has to be a nitai, not a stainless steel. A little bit extra flash here. I probably didn't show this very well, and I will bend it. That helps a lot. If you don't bend it, then all you're doing is just uprighting it. If you bend it, then you'll upright it, and it will help to root correct. But yeah, that's my technique. So hopefully this helps you. If you have any other questions, give me a buzz. Don't hesitate to go to StraightSmileSolutions.com, and we appreciate you subscribing to our YouTube channel. Thank you.